listen, you made my eyes.
One, two.
So I can see. You made my arms.
One, two.
So I can praise you. You made my heart. So I can love. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. You made my hands.
One, two.
For helping others. You made my feet.
One, two.
So I can follow you. You made my legs.
One, two.
To jump for Jesus. You made my heart. So I can love. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. My whole self belongs to you.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Kyle, did it come in the mail today?
Well, Willard, it didn't come yesterday. Maybe it's here today. Let me go check, okay?
Oh, I'm so excited!
Oh, guess what, Willard?
What, Kyle?
Oh, Willard, it came in the mail, look!
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Can you help me unwrap it? I want to see which person I got for my nativity set. Oh, I already have the wise men.
All right, let's get into it.
Oh, who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be?
Ooh, Willard, it looks like Mary.
Oh boy, Mary! Kyle, I don't know who Mary is. Can we call Steve and have him tell us about Mary?
You bet we can, Willard. Great idea. Hey, Steve.
Hey, Kyle. Hi, Willard. Did you guys get Mary today?
Hey, Steve, we did. Hey, can you tell us about Mary and and what we can learn from her?
Oh, I sure can. Today we're gonna be learning, "The Spirit is in my heart." Hey, let's all say that together, everyone.
The spirit is in my heart.
Steve, what's in my heart?
Well, Willard, when we make Jesus the leader of our lives, the Holy Spirit lives in our hearts. And that's what helps us with having joy. The Holy Spirit helps us to know right from wrong.
How did I get the Holy Spirit in my heart, Kyle?
Well, Willard, all you have to do is ask God to be the leader of your life. You say, "God, I want to make you the leader of my life and forgive me for anything bad that I've done." And then God sends the Holy Spirit to be in our hearts.
Well, that's right. And having the Holy Spirit in our hearts is amazing. We're going to be learning about someone who trusted God and the Holy Spirit in their hearts. Her name was Mary. Are you ready, kids?
Oh, I didn't hear them, Kyle.
Me either. Are you ready, kids?
Let's learn about the spirit of Christmas, the Holy Spirit. The Spirit is in my heart. Let's all say that together, everyone. The Spirit is in my heart. I love Christmas because we get to hear the story about baby Jesus and how we can worship him. Our Bible story is in Matthew 2, 1 through 2. This is a true story from the Bible. It really happened, and it goes like this. There was a woman named Mary in the town of Galilee. Mary was going to get married to a man named Joseph. One day, God sent an angel to talk to Mary. The angel's name was Gabriel. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you." Confused and disturbed, Mary tried to think about what the angel could mean. "Don't be afraid, Mary," the angel told her, "for you have found favor with God." Do you think it would make you a little scared if an angel was in front of you? Well, Mary wasn't sure what to do, and she was a little scared. So the angel told her not to be afraid. Then the angel Gabriel told Mary that she would have a baby soon and name him Jesus. "He will be very great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David, and he will reign over Israel forever. His kingdom will never end." That sounds great! But Mary was confused. See, she wasn't married to Joseph yet, so how could she have a baby? The angel replied, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the baby to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God." Mary responded, "I am the Lord's servant. May everything you have said about me come true." And then the angel left her. The Holy Spirit can do amazing things in our lives. For Mary, the Holy Spirit helped her to have baby Jesus. And that's why we celebrate Christmas, because Jesus was born. The Holy Spirit can help us to feel happy and calm, and he helps us to know right from wrong. The Spirit is in my heart. Hey, let's say that together, everyone. The Spirit is in my heart. We have to trust God and Jesus, and we have to trust the Holy Spirit just like Mary did. When we make Jesus the leader of our lives, the Holy Spirit comes and lives in us. And we have to learn to trust that the Holy Spirit helps us. He shows us the truth about God, and he helps us to see right from wrong. The Holy Spirit is amazing in our lives. We can worship Jesus in a lot of different ways, and one of those ways is trusting the Holy Spirit. The Spirit is in my heart. Let's say that together, everyone, one more time. The Spirit is in my heart. Bye, everyone. It was good to see you.
That story was amazing. Mary trusted the Holy Spirit. He was in her heart, too. And then baby Jesus was born.
Oh, wow. Kyle, what will the Holy Spirit help me to do?
Well, Willard, the Holy Spirit can help us do a lot of different things. We might not know everything right away, but we can trust him and he will help us.
Will he help me to worship Jesus?
Yes, he will. Part of how we can trust Jesus is trusting the Holy Spirit and trusting God.
The Spirit is in my heart. Oh, let's say that together, Kyle. The Spirit is in my heart.
Hey kids, I'm Christy. Before we end today, let's practice our memory verse and pray. Our memory verse is Matthew 4, 10b. "You must worship the Lord your God and serve only him." The Spirit is in my heart. Let's say that together. The Spirit is in my heart. Remember, Jesus loves you so much and he wants to be your friend. Let's all pray together. Put your hands together and bow your head. Dear Lord, thank you so much for making me. And thank you for giving me the Holy Spirit in my heart. Help me to worship you every day. Amen. Bye, kids.